What's the first thing that comes to mind when you think about Saudi Arabia? Desert, camels, an arid landscape? Well, looks like it's time to change that view, for Saudi Arabia is now bringing its desert to life. Hey everyone, welcome back to our video. In today's video, we're going to be talking about how Saudi Arabia is bringing the desert to life. So, let's begin. With its desert landscape, Saudi Arabia is Middle East's biggest country by area. Furthermore, it accounts for 72% of its GDP. Their advancement in agriculture over the last three decades is nothing short of being astounding. Large areas of desert have been converted to agricultural fields, a significant achievement in a nation with one of the lowest rates of rainfall in the world. Saudi Arabia is now not all about oil. The nation, which was once importing 80% of its food supply, today exports wheat, dates, dairy products, eggs, fish, poultry, fruits, vegetables, and flowers into the international market. Agriculture has come across as a key focus for sustainability. In the 1970s, serious large-scale agricultural development began, and by 1984, Saudi Arabia became self-sufficient in wheat. Shortly after that, it began exporting wheat to 30 countries. It was not only wheat that they started exporting, but fruits and vegetables, meats and milk too. Did you know that Saudi Arabia has some of the most modern and largest dairy farms in the Middle East? Their milk production boasts a remarkable productive annual rate of 6,800 liters per cow, one of the highest in the world. The government started a massive initiative to promote modern farming technologies, built rural roads, irrigation networks, storage and export facilities, and supports agricultural research and training institutes. As a result, the production of all fundamental foods has increased dramatically. Saudi Arabia is currently entirely self-sufficient in various consumables. Coming to offshore fishing has consistently increased fish output, and the kingdom is looking for methods to boost its harvest further by encouraging more private involvement. Aquaculture is one of the emerging sectors in which the private sector invests with government assistance. The number of fish farms, whether in the sea or in tanks on land, has been continuously expanding. The majority of them are near Saudi Arabia's Red Sea coast, and shrimp aquaculture has seen a lot of success. The fast change of the kingdom from a wheat importer to an exporter was its most notable agricultural achievement. The country's first grain silos were erected in 1978. Other grains such as barley, sorghum, and millet are also grown in large quantities by Saudi farmers. In recent years, the yield of wheat and other grains has been drastically reduced to conserve valuable water resources. The kingdom, on the other hand, has increased fruit and vegetable output through upgrading agricultural practices. Saudi Arabia exports fruits and vegetables to its neighbors in large quantities. Watermelon, grapes, citrus fruits, onions, squash, and tomatoes are among the most prolific crops. The Al-Hikmah Research Station in Jizan, in the country's well-watered southwest, grows tropical fruits such as pineapples, pawpaws, bananas, mangoes, and guavas. All of that in the land of the desert. Needless to say, the government has a very big role to play. The provision of low-interest loans and technical support services were initiated to tackle the problem. Low-cost water, fuel, and energy, as well as duty-free imports of raw materials and machinery, have benefited agriculture. Foreign joint venture partners of Saudi people or firms are free from paying taxes for up to 10 years, and investment laws since April 2000 provide further benefits. Most of all, the Ministry of Agriculture is the major institution in charge of putting agricultural policy into action, as well as providing research and extension services to farmers. The Saudi Arabian Agricultural Bank distributes subsidies that gives interest-free loans. Furthermore, the Grain Silos and Flour Mills Organization was founded in 1972 to buy and store wheat, build flour mills, and make animal feed to help agriculture flourish across the country. In Saudi Arabia, water is limited, and water is highly essential for any progress, especially when it comes to agriculture. So, what's the solution? The kingdom looked for new means to ensure that it has adequate water to maintain its expansion. That's where aquifers come into the picture. They are massive underground water reservoirs. The government made a huge effort in the 1970s to discover, map, and estimate the capacity of such aquifers. As a consequence, it was able to dig tens of thousands of deep tube wells for both urban and agricultural usage in the most promising places. Let's not forget the sea, which is another significant source of water, with optimum desalination, a procedure that converts saline salt water into drinkable water. Saudi Arabia is known to produce the most desalinated water in the world. The Saline Water Conversion Corporation owns and runs 27 desalination plants that generate over 3 million cubic meters of drinkable water each day. These facilities produce about 70% of the water consumed in cities, as well as a significant amount of industrial demands. And that's just not it. They are also a significant source of electric power. The administration utilized water from flash floods, which were directed into dams and stored as surface water. Today, more than 200 dams collect an estimated 16 billion cubic feet of runoff each year in their reservoirs. Wadi Jizan, Wadi Fatima, Wadi Bisha, and Najran include some of the largest of the dams. This water is mostly utilized for agriculture and is distributed across enormous areas of previously fallow land via thousands of kilometers of irrigation canals. Between 1983 and 1990, the average annual increase in new wheat-growing land was up by 14% thanks to a 35% rise in yield per ton. This puts Saudi Arabia up on the map as the sixth biggest exporter of wheat. The Saudi Ministry of Environment, Water, and Agriculture have more exciting plans lined up. It announced a new strategy in 2018 to boost organic agriculture by 300%. With a budget of $200 million set aside. Despite all the efforts, Saudi Arabia is experiencing a significant loss of water in its subsurface aquifers, which has resulted in breakdown and disintegration of its agriculture. The country has now purchased agricultural property in the United States, Argentina, Indonesia, Thailand, and Africa as a result of the catastrophe to keep up with the zealous ambition. Do you think Saudi Arabia will continue to thrive in its agricultural feat? Let us know in the comments section below. Governments can go to great lengths to heighten the prosperity of their country. If you enjoyed this video, we recommend you watch our next video titled How Dubai Made Its Artificial Islands. Hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure to like, share, and subscribe to our channel for more amazing videos, and we'll see you next time.